Ashes! It's time for Ed's Night Party! Tonight, from TV's Diff'rent Strokes, Dana Plato! Plus, Pat Buchanan's Movie Guide! And The Brighter Side! And don't forget, the gyrations of the Zubar dancers! And now, here's your host, Humble Howard!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Welcome to Ed's Night Party, a show with style, class, and grace. and an audience full of meekle? An audience full of people making fart noises. Well, isn't that nice? I got this book this week. It's called Instant ESP. Can you see that? Instant ESP. Now, it's got to be a scam because I'm thinking, how can you learn to read people's minds from a book? I mean, I'm getting a feeling. You got a bad headache, but I think I'm feeling something.
I've got a bomb and I'm going to blow this place sky high.
Hey, wait a second there, buddy. A bomb! A bomb! Security! Take him away! There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, the Ed's Night Party players there. Thank you. I'm sure glad I had the book, or else I never would have known the bomber was there. We got a great show for you tonight from Diff'rent Strokes. Dana Plato is here, ladies and gentlemen. As well as The Brighter Side and so much more. And now, without further ado and delay, please welcome the star of Ed's Night Party, Ed the Sock, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. This is so much, it's more spring-like, you know.
Yeah, you know, is that it? Is that in spring you're supposed to wear, like, a shirt with a conflicting pattern from the jacket? Is that what it's...
Is it?
What are you dressed with your eyes shut?
All right, we got a lot of program here.
Dana Plato, and
so much other things.
And you know, it's time we should start our program off this week with trying to turn that frown into a smile.
That's right, the brighter side of...
The welfare state.
There you go.
Because, you know, there's been a lot of apparently a popular topic. There's been a lot of attacks on the...
All right. There's a brighter side of everything.
That's
The brighter side of the welfare state.
Because, you know, a lot of people are knocking the welfare state.
Yeah.
Now governments are trying to dismantle it. But there is a brighter side to the welfare
Bring
state.
Bring it on.
All right, number one. It improves road safety by knowing that we can pay people to fill the potholes that we last week paid somebody to dig. The welfare state helps keep the birth rate high by providing unemployed single mothers with an incentive to stay home and have even more kids. It's fun watching the deficit run up like the tote board on the Jerry Lewis telethon. Contributes to the health of the economy by stimulating the sales of beer and lottery tickets.
People sure enough like that one.
By having universally subsidized education, we're creating the world's most educated force of burger flippers and fry shops.
Yeah.
Without the taxes that are necessary for the social welfare state, we would just blow our money on things like living expenses.
And finally,
government housing, one-stop shopping for drugs and hookers.
Did you see what we did there? Took the frown and turned it upside down. Did you see what we did there?
What are you, Georgie Jessel?
Hey, did you see?
You know what's good about that Georgie Jethro reference?
No.
You and I get it. No one else.
You know what? There's a lot of the show that's like that nowadays.
I know.
We got something else to go to. This is very interesting.
Now, don't hold it up yet.
I'm not going to.
All right.
Hey?
All right. Don't be premature, my friend.
Well, I wouldn't. Hey. I wouldn't.
All right.
Hey.
Because, you know, in the States, the Republicans have come down pretty heavily against the media, saying that there's a lot of images and movies and messages that are really bad for the United States.
Yeah,
and
I've heard that.
Of course, the whole Western world.
Nasty Republicans.
Bob Dole put out a little list, and Pat Buchanan has gone further than putting out a list. He's actually made a book to help guide us to finding movies with proper, decent messages and stay away from the bad ones. We thought we'd read some of that today. Why don't we show that book?
Should I show the book now?
Yes.
The book now. Okay. There's the book, kid.
Pat Buchanan's Movie Encyclopedia.
Can you read that? Go closer, right there.
It's a white man's guide to movies made by Jews who control the media.
There you go.
Forward by Marlon Brando.
Yeah, it's Marlon Brando's personal pick. Okay.
All right, here we go. So I'll start.
Let's get started. All right, here's the book, just in case you forget. There's the book.
The first movie.
There we go.
Gremlins, the plot. Family adopts cute little animal. Within days, the animal is multiplied by the hundreds and turned the town into a living hell.
Right.
Pat's pick. Subtle yet telling allegory of how one cute little immigrant will soon be followed by hundreds more who will then turn good white neighborhoods into slums.
There we go. All right.
You want to read one, Howard?
I got a couple here. Poltergeist. Demons from hell possess a little girl in suburbia using the family TV set as a conduit to our world. Pat's pick, good movie, shows TV as the agent of Satan.
There you go. A vampire in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Plot. Eddie Murphy as a vampire who comes to America, preys on the blood of citizens, and falls in love with a woman. Pat's pick? A timely illustration of how dark-skinned foreigners are sucking the blood of Americans and despoiling our women. All right, I'll do another one.
You do another one.
Casper.
Casper.
Plot. The adventures of a friendly ghost and his mischievous ghostly uncle. Pat's pick? I like any movie where the hero is wearing a white sheet.
We've all remember the movie A Pretty Woman. Plot, a prostitute meets and runs away with a wealthy Prince Charming. Pat's pick, thumbs up, shows a woman willing to give up her career for a man.
There you go. Woo! Here you go. Batman Forever.
Batman Forever.
Plot, the brooding crime fighter and his youthful assistant battle the evil forces of Two-Face and the Riddler. Pat's pick, immoral. Shows two young single guys living together, cruising the night in rubber suits.
Okay. All right, then. Showgirls, the plot, a beautiful young woman claws her way to the top of the world of stripping. Pat's pick, good to see a woman who isn't interested in taking a man's job.
Natural born killers. What?
Yeah.
Two middle Americans go on a crime and murder spree, becoming nationally famous. Pat's pick, good to see white youngsters succeeding in a field dominated by swarthy ethnics.
And, Thelma and Louise. Plot, two women abandon their humdrum, male-dominated lives and strike out to find their independence. Pat's pick, good movie, shows that left alone, women can't drive.
Pocahontas. Plot.
There you go.
A delightful animated musical featuring a love story between an Indian princess and a white settler. Pat's pick, interracial aspects aside, it's good to finally see a movie where natives are happy and singing while we take their land and carry out genocide against them.
There you go.
And one more. One more.
And there's one more.
Ghostbusters. Plot. A team of scientists chase down the ghouls, demons, and spooks that haunt New York. Pat's pick. I haven't seen it, but I like any film that shows white guys chasing spooks. Pat Buchanan. It's Pat Buchanan.
Don't you get the point?
It's satire.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dana Plato's our guest. Hang around. It's Ed's Night Party. Don't go away, all right? everybody.
Gotta love those Zubar girls.
The Zubar dancers.
The Zubar dancers. By the way, did I mention what happened at the Zubar last week?
No.
Two lesbians were dancing naked on the stage.
Mm-hmm.
It was terrible. You know why? Wasn't enough light for my video camera.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest tonight was a child star for years on the wildly popular Diff'rent Strokes. Who knows? She may have seen Gary Coleman naked. Let's hope not. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Dana Plato. Woo!
Great to have you. Thank you.
Great
to see you. So glad you got here.
Hey.
Watch yourself here. Easy
now. Help getting that up.
I do want to brush you off, but you know, I'm a married man. I have a child.
How you doing?
I'm good, honey. How are you?
I have the biggest crush on you. I'm renewing it now.
He's thinking, Dana, he's thinking of a Diff'rent Strokes of a different type, too, completely. He's not.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah, you don't want to go there.
I'm sure yet.
Well, it's great to have you here. I know we had a little problem, but you know, it's you're here and that's
I'm
all
here.
That matters.
Yes.
How did you land the role?
Of Kimberly?
On Diff'rent Strokes.
Well, that's really interesting that you asked that.
Right, because it's right there.
Good, because otherwise it'd be a damn boring interview.
Yeah.
It's great, this guy's great.
Yeah.
Okay, I was in a cheerleading squad at the time, and I had already been acting for 6 years. But I wasn't auditioning for Diff'rent Strokes, and I auditioned for the Gong Show.
Come on.
Did
you audition for that show?
I auditioned for the Gong Show.
How old a young woman at the time would you be like?
I was 12.
Wow.
I was 12. I didn't mean to slobber on you there. Sorry.
That's okay.
Did I get to?
No.
I love the slobber.
Let me get that
off. There'll be a lot more later, honey.
Okay.
Yeah. That's nice.
And
Kimberly's here.
And one of the producers on Diff'rent Strokes saw that tape, and they asked me to come into the office.
But so you've done some acting.
I'd like you to come into the office.
Oh, brutal, isn't it?
So you're 12 years old at the time, and this and you know they do so many pilots in Los Angeles, and you do the show, and you think, well, okay, there you go. And how soon did you know that it was like it was a perennial top 10 for years? I mean, how soon before you got caught up in this phenomenon?
It was so cool. I was so blessed with that show. It was a wonderful thing. It just kind of happened. I mean, I worked real hard to get to that point.
Right.
You know, you work real hard. It took me 101 auditions to get my first job. And After that, it was just kind of like a domino effect. You know, because I was, I'm not, you know, drop dead beautiful. I've always been like the kid next
door. Come on.
No, it's just that.
What do you think?
Stop! That is very, very sweet.
But at this time, you're 12 years old. The show gets started. And it zooms to the top of the TV things there.
Don't let him... ratings?
Yeah, that's what
I'm... What are you, the Incredible Hulk? You don't have a vocabulary?
No, I've turned into Tonto.
All of a sudden...
your TV show good. Oh, I like it. So does my brother. Anyway...
That was Cheech and Chong.
Your show... Yeah. Hulk like show.
Let him answer
I'm asking the question.
All of a sudden you do Lou Ferrigno.
So tell me, it became a phenomenon there. You're only like a 12 or 13 year old. First of all, how many years did the show run?
It ran with me for 8 years.
Eight years?
Yeah, it's incredible. Oh, it was such a blessing.
How many years did it run after you left?
One.
See?
Yeah.
See, they shouldn't have gone on without you.
Thank
Everyone
you.
Thought it was that little bugger Gary Coleman.
Yeah. He is very wonderful to work with.
Right.
Did you and Willis ever get anything going?
No! We were very much like brother and sister. We used to brawl verbally before. I mean, the man would be counting down 5, 4, 3, 2 to cameras turning on, and boom, we were brawling.
I wouldn't say boom around Willis. Apparently he blew up a garage.
Oh, that's terrible.
It is terrible, but it's true. Now, it's terrible. Yeah, I'd hate to owe Willis any money for any reason. Now, tell me, when the whole thing, you're in People Magazine, it's running for 8 years, and what was the reason you left the program?
Well, the reason that they let me go was because I was pregnant with my son Tyler.
Oh.
Well, it was the best thing that's ever happened to me. It's now 11.
Gary Coleman or anything.
No, it wasn't. I was married. To Lanny Lambert, and we're still very good friends.
I think you're not married still.
No.
That would have been tough to explain on the show that Sister Kimberly was all...
Well, they were going to move her down the hall marry Kimberly the next season, and we had a whole hiatus coming where I could have had Tyler, and really no one would have known. If you just kind of sat me at the desk or popped my head out of the bathroom like they did anyway.
I'm pregnant now.
So it's a...
Yeah, yeah. No, Miss Pat. Whatever. So you got pregnant and they asked you to go have your kid.
Yeah, it was very interesting. I basically got permission to be pregnant because it's something you don't do, especially when you're a child.
That
starts on a show.
So how old were you at that time?
I'm 19.
Yeah, you need permission to have a child at 19.
No, I needed permission from the producers, because...
So you have to go to Conrad Bain and ask him?
Yeah. did you like call the producers in the middle of the night and say, listen, I'm about to have some good sex here. Can I get pregnant? That's you holding the phone, by the way. Did you all catch that? So, 8 years... I want to talk about something that I find interesting. Now, 8 years of doing a big network show like that.
Yeah.
And I don't want to be indiscreet here, but did you make a lot of money from that? And do you still make money from it now? Because it runs everywhere.
Yeah, it's such a blessing when you've got a TV. There's so much. It's incredible how much money is involved with something like that. See, we're having fun. We're working hard. Yes, we're working hard, but we're having fun working hard. Everyone's got to work. Yes, and it was wonderful. It really was wonderful.
So do you still get paid sometime in the year from Diff'rent Strokes?
Well, now what happens is that it's on syndication all over the world.
Right.
What you talking about? Sorry, I had to throw that in. I'm about as tall as him, too.
Just for a moment there, he... And, for a moment there, he actually looked like him, too.
Yeah.
Forgive me, Gary. I'm sorry.
I don't have any kidneys either.
Oh, that was brutal. And so
how many kidneys did they get paid for the show? No, I'm just no. So. You know, you're a bad influence on me.
Yeah, I know.
So you're saying it runs in syndication, and so to this very day, do you still get some payment
from it? I do. What happens now is that the network that buys the most shows, I get paid for. So if, say, eight different networks buy it for a year, I only get paid by one of those networks.
It's a rip-off.
Yeah.
Bunch of crooks.
They are.
Now how much does Mr. Drummond get? He's already rich. You ever see that guy anymore, Conrad Bain?
No, but I speak with him, and he's such a wonderful man.
He has a
man.
Twin
he's
brother,
a great actor.
He's a great actor.
He does have a brother, and he
he's
was a great
a
actor
twin
long
brother.
Before
twin
that.
Twin brother.
Yeah, he comes from Broadway.
And Conrad Bain apparently is from some small town in Canada somewhere.
Yeah.
That's what I heard.
Yeah, he's a wonderful man.
What a fascinating little story
there.
Well, you know something.
Yeah!
Woo! So,
I have to ask a question. Aren't you partially responsible for that Facts of Life spinoff?
Oh, yes, I
have
to.
What the hell was that all about? That song, I can't get out of my head. When the boys that used to hate you, back to life, back to life.
I really like, that's who he looks like. He looks like Oscar from Sesame Street.
No, I thought you were going to say I look like Mrs. Garrett. years with my head in the oven.
You look vaguely like Andy Cohen.
Now, how did you get involved with this famous Playboy spread?
Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
I
thought it was.
Thank you.
You know, it's weird because we watched you on TV and we all thought you were like the little sweet Kimberly. The next thing is like, whoa, Kimberly's all grown up. Where did Kimberly get these?
Yeah, they used to hide them.
They used
to find them.
Don't ever hide them. They're a beautiful thing.
So you were, that was a really... different thing for you to do career-wise.
It was a different stroke.
It was great. Touché. That was good. That was good.
So they approached you?
Yeah, it was great. I have the utmost respect for Playboy. I think it's a wonderful magazine. I really do.
What do you think of Swank?
don't. I want to hear this. I thought that was fascinating. They called you up and you said, yeah,
they called me up and I was just, I thought to myself, I didn't say it to them, but like, I will pay you money to let me be in your magazine.
It's very flattering,
I think that's
great.
It really is. I couldn't even believe they wanted me, you know. And we did a week shoot in the desert, and I'll never forget the very first day. Okay.
No one ever forgets their very first
day. We're in the desert.
Yeah.
In the desert. Not just in the desert, but in the desert. Okay? There's dirt. They throw a mattress down on the ground. They throw a bucket of ice water on me.
Yeah.
Then they go. And I said, what? You know? And they said, well, go,
let's get
go
busy.
On. They said, let's get to work. And I said, okay. And he says, well, let's, you know, go make it happen. Go make it work.
What kind of opening line is that?
And I thought to myself, I can't even believe this. This is insane. I'm not embarrassed. I'm not intimidated. I'm not shy.
Yeah.
I'm nothing like that.
Well,
but I didn't know what to do by myself.
You've had a fascinating life.
Yeah.
And we're really glad you made the effort to do our show. And
we wish
you much success.
Thank you so
for
much
it.
For having me.
Dana Plato, everybody. Come on.
Thank you.
Hey, if you're going to be in the Toronto area and you'd like free tickets to see Ed's Night Party, all you got to do is call us. U.S. and Canada, 1-800-3-SOCKME. In Toronto, 416-599-5333. Now back to Ed's Night Party, brought to you by Molson Canadian.
Welcome back to Ed's Night Party. We couldn't let Dana go without asking you what you're doing now.
I start a film Wednesday, and it's called Jack, Jill, and Jill, and I play a lesbian.
Well, I want to say, no one's happier about that than Ed.
You never believe it.
Dana Plato, thanks for doing the show. We sure appreciate it.
Thank you. We hope you
had a good time.
Like I always say, folks. You don't have anything good to say. Say it often.
Good night, everybody. Take care. That was great, man.
Thank you.
Okay?
Thank you so much.
Coming up next.